catch him kicking through the door. Let's go. At 18, H-O-P, bet on me. You gon' see, ain't no thing, but I'm on. Bitch, I'm kicking through the door. Yeah, at 18, H-O-P, bet on me. Prodigy, when I hit the track, bitch, I'm gone.
I'm gone, I'm gone, I'm gone.
Yeah, homie G, the code MC, rolling deep to your vicinity.
Yeah.
I just had an epiphany, I don't know what it did to me, but I'm hoping the devil doesn't get into me. Mm. Still a beast, poops, it is me, it's finna be off the chain with a brand new delivery.
Yeah.
Try to get in my way, to feel in the rage, to sit in my brain, and then I blast you to smithereens. Please, I'll be damned if I'm thrown on the back burner. Maniac purging, a rap server, the cat burglar who be committing mass murder. That's word at the G-O-D, the game from the POV. Begging they plead on knees, I'll be no peace, the D-O-G, I feed on beats. Wanna die, they can lean on me, no deal with us. You pee, I done built it up, you wishing you was in the field with us. I'm the ill, no deal, look at me grill. With me, then I will erupt, still we must remain calm. Napalm in my dang palm, I'm a dark villain like Blaze Spawn. An Akon with a cape on, it ain't fun, you can't run. This is a horror flick, your life is based on.
I ain't gonna say that I'm running shit, that's the shit every rapper saying. Think about just going and look at the bank account. I just don't have enough patience to take it out. This hate now, I don't suffer from no paper drought. Always win is my favorite route, my whole life I just lay it out.
Just kickboxing. I want to see three punches finished with a kick. You got that? Finish that combo with a kick. You gotta throw more strikes or he's gonna see that kick coming.
Strikes.
more strikes before your kicks. Kicks up. Keep working. Push yourself. Move. Set it up. Something happened. Strikes. You're not training to your ability. There's no way we can move forward like this.
Hey everyone, I'm Megan O'Leary, and this is your UFC Minute. The UFC returns this weekend with a fresh face who is destined to make headlines. When UFC president Dana White went looking for a fight, he was hoping that he would end up with a future UFC star. And those are the expectations after he signed a regional champion who has dominated the local lightweight circuit en route to his octagon debut this weekend. That's it for today. Stay tuned for your next UFC Minute, and I'll see you at the fights.
All right, coming up next, it's a UFC lightweight division bout. Well, he was discovered on Dana White looking for a fight, and man, did he come through with style points that night. As such, here he is, making his UFC debut a few short months later. And the question beckons, will there be jitters? You hear a lot about those UFC nerves, and sometimes it leads to an adrenaline dump, and that can be the difference in a win or a loss. So if you can bottle the nerves and deal with the bright lights of the Bang Octagon, there's no denying the skill set, the skills, the demeanor. That's what got us to the big show. We'll see if he can perform now in the U.S.
This guy is an excellent striker. What he wants to do is utilize his footwork, his takedown defense, land hard strikes to get the victory.
Well, what a pop from the crowd as this guy makes the walk. Such a well-rounded fighter, and you got to think when the opponent breaks him down on film, not a lot of weaknesses jump out of the video. This is a true mixed martial artist. May not stand out in any one area, but plus skills across the board. Probably comfortable just about anywhere this fight goes tonight.
This guy is a very well-rounded fighter. You never know what he's gonna do. His striking is world-class, his ground game is excellent, and he mixes them up very well.
And now our tail of the tape for this lightweight scrap. So more than 10 years apart, these two fighters, with some differences in height and a similar reach. And now to get us started, here is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is 3 rounds in the UFC lightweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, making his UFC debut here tonight. He stands 6'1" tall, weighing in at 155 pounds, fighting out of Mecca, Saudi Arabia, Golden. And now introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner, a mixed martial artist with a professional record of 4 wins, 3 losses. He stands 5'10" tall, weighing in at 154 pounds, fighting out of London, England, and when the action begins, our referee in charge, Mario Yamasaki.
So Mario Yamasaki, the veteran, draws the opening assignment here. We are ready to go with round one here. All right, so here we go with round one. After winning his fight on Dana White, looking for a fight, he has arrived at the UFC debut. And when you have this type of height and this type of pressure, sometimes fighters succumb to it. But when you talk to this young man, you don't get the sense that he will. Supremely competent, and really feels like this UFC debut could have come a few years ago. He is ready to go. We'll see if he can get off to a good start tonight. Getting the hands going here early. Ooh, blocks the shot. Lands a kick to the leg here, Joe. Oh, beautiful kick to the body there, and he just left himself wide open for that strike. Very vulnerable by leaning in, keeping the guard high to allow for an opening down low. Going to the kick here, Joe.
Just missed with a huge kick.
Oh, nice kick to the head.
Caught him with a punch.
Just misses with the straight with Tazza. Oh, how good is that jab? Oh, roundhouse kick. Add that to his highlight reel.
He got tagged there.
Yep, not a ton behind it, but it landed.
Nice inside leg kick.
Kick lands for him there.
Oh, powerful right leg kick.
Oh, doing a damn good job with those leg kicks, Joe. And now you'll start to see his opponent slow down.
And he lands the roundhouse.
And he connects there.
Big kick lands.
Some real power shots here. Oh, straight right.
These guys are swinging. Nasty combinations here. Tagged him.
Oh, continues to land those jabs at will. Nice way to keep the opponent at distance. First takedown attempt is there.
Hip escape. Gets out of the full mount. Reversal. Very nice.
Able to land with the left hand there.
Moves to north-south.
Right back up to his feet.
Whoa, he hurt him. He's rocked. Oh, big left.
Timely defense there. Huge block for him. 5 minutes in the books.
There's a nice leg kick. And here's another beautiful leg kick. And there's another excellent leg kick. We really got a chance to see some awesome action in that round.
Thank you very much. Ariane Celeste is here.
Now, starting off this round, he might still be hurt. He's going to want to look to be defensive and move and avoid getting hit and try to recover.
Visibly limping here. And kick. And he lands the hook. Mixes it up nicely in terms of staying heavy and also staying active. Working out of that southpaw stance. Lands flush with the left hand.
Good combination so far from both men.
Oh, look at him snap off the jab. That's pretty to watch. Beautiful employment of the jab here. Well, you've got to admire the effort. He's still striking. He's still landing. But the gas tank is basically on empty. Let's see if he can preserve it here moving forward. Left his head wide open to absorb that straight hand. He has shown a vulnerability here by leaning in right into his opponent's range.
Slightly deflected.
Oh, he might be out. Oh.
It's very wobbly. He's trying to hang on.
Beautiful body shot. Well, a really good second round for him thus far. After a somewhat lackluster first round, he has found the rhythm and found his striking range. Scary proposition for the opponent now here in round two.
And he eats a high one.
Oh, his face is painted with blood, Joe. The cut on that cheek not getting any better.
Leg kick.
1 minute to go in the round.
He's got a beautiful leg kick.
45 seconds remain in the round. Checks the leg kick.
He's hurt.
Oh! In the books. All right, that's the end of the round, and you see the cut on the cheek. That thing is getting downright nasty. It is getting worse here by the minute, and you got to wonder to what extent does that impact him moving forward here in this fight. You at least have to ask the question.
Here's a big leg kick. Here we see a beautifully timed kick connects flush. perfectly placed strike here lands on target. Really excellent striking being displayed in that round.
Good to have Brazil's Jenny Andrade in the building here.
Hardy,
comes courtesy of some outstanding ground and pound, and it's one thing to try to score when you have your opponent in a compromised position on the ground. It's another thing to try to end the fight, and that's exactly what he was trying to do here tonight. Elbows and punches and hammer fists, one weapon after the next, and ultimately the knockout materializes. Nicely done there.
And here we see it from another camera angle.
Much better than he did tonight. A huge knockout under the lights. We'll be talking about that one for some time. Now we go inside the octagon. Bruce Buffer with the official decision.
Stop to this contest at 30 seconds of round number three. Playing the winner by knockout, Golden.
All right, so congratulations to the winner, off to a nice 1-0 start in the UFC. This was his promotional debut, and it could not have gone much better for him here tonight. As he starts to celebrate with his coaches and teammates, congratulations to the UFC newcomer.
Darling, I see that you're dangerous. You got a lot of dudes for a pacing. I stay true to the statements. We should go wild and enjoy the acquaintance. Wanna give you the keys to the cars that I don't have when I build you a four. Charge that they give you in court. Do anything just to feel the alarm. Jesus, they charge. She got a bump that defines all odds. I got reach within 18 yards. Type of candy that don't dissolve. Jesus, they charge. All her contacts filled with stars. I'ma take her to this club, but she got danger to us all. Danger.
With women who engage in essence, a vibe is so relentless. I give it not back because I got the message. Now we slowly dancing, whisper in the air, why you so enchanting? Grabs me by the waist and replies, I'm attracted to cool and handsome. We step out the bar.
Rib, I guess I came up out the darkness. The mood changed when I sparked it. Now I'm pausing.
Hey, yo, East,
It's your man Nas Esco. Keep doing what you do. Peace be unto you, my young brother, Young King.
UFC lightweight division bout.
Alright,
so here he is, a very accomplished striker, finally making the walk to the octagon tonight. Jonathan Gill be interested, of course, in keeping this fight standing in his wheelhouse. And he's got the takedown defense to keep this fight where he wants it. No doubt, he'll be looking to put on a striking clinic here tonight.
This guy is an excellent striker. What he wants to do is utilize his footwork, his takedown defense, land hard strikes to get the victory.
Trot out the term well-rounded in modern-day mixed martial arts, maybe more than we should, but this guy fits the bill. Maybe doesn't stand out in any one area on film, but plus skills everywhere. And you gotta think tonight, Joe, with his skill set, he's more than comfortable really anywhere this fight goes. If he needs to stand and strike, he can do it. If the fight hits the canvas, he can submit you. A lot of different skills brought to the table by this young man.
This guy is a very well-rounded fighter. He can do it all. If the fight takes place standing or on the ground, he's going to be comfortable in all areas of the game.
And now our tale of the tape for this lightweight fight. More than 5 years apart, with similar height and some differences in reach. Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is 3 rounds in the UFC lightweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, a kickboxer holding a professional record of 4 wins, no losses. He stands 6'1" tall, weighing in at 155 pounds. Fighting out of Mecca, Saudi Arabia, Golden. And now introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner. This man is a mixed martial artist, holding a professional record of 4 wins, 3 losses. He stands 6 feet tall, weighing in at 155 pounds. Fighting out of Seoul, South Korea, Grandmaster. And when the action begins, our referee in charge, Eve Loving.
The veteran Eve Loving draws the assignment here.
You ready? You ready?
And we are underway. So he won his UFC debut by knockout. So you got to think the confidence is sky high as he tries to move to 2-0 in the big show here tonight. No nerves whatsoever when he made the UFC debut, and the results really spoke to that. So now a little bit more pressure on him, added audience, more eyeballs. We'll see if he can respond to that pressure and deliver another knockout performance here tonight.
And lands a good shot. Oh, power kick to the arms.
Tags him with the left hand.
Oh! He clipped him.
Tagged him again.
Oh!
Huge right hand!
He is hurt. Oh, head kick.
Oh, another head kick lands flush. He has got to start blocking these, Joe. One more, and he could be down on the canvas looking up at the lights.
Absolutely. Powerful leg kick.
Under 3 minutes now to go in what has been a very fast-paced opening round here. Head kick is blocked. Oh, clipped him with the jab.
He just landed an outstanding leg kick.
Trying to establish that jab once again. Well, that kick landed the body beautifully placed right underneath that elbow. Let's see if he makes the adjustments now defensively to avoid opening up that midsection to further damage by that kick.
Good punch.
How about that shin?
And he eats a kick.
Continues to mix it up, going to the head, mixing in some body shots.
Good 1-2.
Joey missed with that straight right attempt.
Yeah, he's digging into that leg kick.
Flipped him with the jab.
Good job of timing strikes here. Oh, man, with that right leg kick.
Connects with the punch there. Oh, doing a damn good job with those leg kicks, Joe. And now you'll start to see his opponent slow down.
Great combinations. I like the way he's mixing these up.
Some nice back and forth action here.
Huge kick to the body.
Back and forth we go. Oh, huge shot there. And there's that inside leg kick.
Oh, and he's down. Switches southpaw. Nice leg kick.
10 seconds to go in round one.
Oh! Wow! Here's a huge punch that stuns. Here's a powerful punch that devastates. And let's see that again.
Jenny Andrade to get us going.
You ready? You ready?
Round two is underway.
At the end of that round, his opponent was clearly hurt. He's going to look to start this round off fast and try to pick up where he left off. Front kick to the face.
Well, the offense has been there. He is landing some good shots, but not really stringing them together and putting combinations on his opponent. He's got to mix up his strikes, change his tempo a little bit, and try to get his opponent out of there by landing more than just one strike at a time. We show you the total strikes. All right, so some fatigue striking, I guess you would call it here. He is landing, but just not inflicting much damage because his stamina is on low.
That one hurt.
Able to check that kick as well. L- Lands a kick to the leg here, Joe.
Oh! Kicked him in the face!
Oh, he might be out.
He's in big trouble.
Oh, man. Well, his corner was pretty urgent after round one. A little bit lackluster there in that opening round. He has certainly picked up the pace here, and as a result, he has taken control of this second round. He landed that inside leg kick.
Again.
Oh, really doing a nice job timing his shot, staying busy in this round.
Good short punch there. Oh, landed it. Good shot.
Just missing on the high kick there. Strong inside leg kick. Under 2 minutes now to go in round two. Lands an outside leg kick of his own.
Caught that one on the forearm.
Inside leg kick.
Fainting with the punch. Oh, nice. Excellent defense here. Really good job blocking all those shots coming at his head. Oh, powerful right leg kick.
Less than a minute now to go in round two. So his opponent lands that kick to the body, Joe, and he has shown an increased susceptibility to that strike here tonight.
The kick gets through.
Oh, how about the bruise on the outside of his thigh? He might need to start switching stances here, Joe, to protect that leg and have fun walking tomorrow. Out. Yep, not a ton behind it, but it landed. Oh, and he goes to the hook now. It's good. Oh! 2 rounds in the books. All right, so there's the end of the round. Big story in this one now. The cut on the bridge of that nose from that strike. The cut man is in there. Should be able to shut this one and potentially prevent it from being a factor here moving forward.
Here's a devastating kick that does some serious damage. Let's see it one more time.
Ariane Celeste is holding it down.
Are you ready? You ready?
Fight. Third round underway. Oh, he found the target there, Joe. Nice punch. How about that shin? Very nice leg kick for him there. Can't take too many of those. Now mixing one into the body.
Whenever you see a fighter's legs stiffen up like that, that's not a good sign. Oh, and he ate a front kick.
Oh, shot to the body connects there. He hasn't really thrown too many body strikes in this fight, but now, as this fight goes on, he is not discriminating, working the body, and those shots are going to count. Well, the strike lands, but he is visibly fatigued, Joe, and as such, not doing a whole lot of damage at this point in the fight.
Man, he's trying to stay up. He is in big, big trouble. Oh, very nice. Oh, what a leg kick.
Oh!
Hurt him bad. Oh, that's it. Wow. 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 Landed a hard kick for the knockout.
Yeah, Joe, as far as highlights go, they don't get much prettier than that. A huge kick to end the night here tonight. He caught his opponent flush, full force, full extension, and that one was a no-doubter. The fight was over as soon as that foot made contact.
Let's see that again.
Well, hard to perform much better than he did tonight. A huge knockout under the lights. They'll be talking about that one for some time. We go back inside the octagon for the official decision. It resides with Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Eve Leving has called a stop to this contest at 2:04 of the third round. Declaring the winner by knockout, Grandmaster.
So there he is, the man of the moment. Certainly maximized the showcase here tonight, Joey. Gets a big win by way of the knockout. Certainly kept the judges out of it here tonight. Perhaps some bonus money is coming his way, but there will be no wiping the smile off of his face tonight. He will party deep into the night with his friends, his family. A huge knockout turned in by that man here tonight, and he has set himself up for a huge fight now moving forward inside the octagon.
Annoying. If you rapping all day when you selling dope, then another fraud ass studio dope man who be spit, but don't ever go there. I know a couple about it, man. That shit is so rare. You drop a mixtape every summer, still don't care, man. This high ain't meant for everybody. It's insane. I'm blown out my brain. Blown out my brain. I'm blown out my brain. Blown out my brain. I'm blown out my brain. The nicotine to addiction. In the hood like an engine. Addies with no prescription. Wipe my ass with opinions. Despicable as a minion. Pulling milfs at pavilions. As old as Kimora Simmons. And thick as the plot is getting. The black Jeremy Piven. Attitude is malicious. Running your office tripping. Entourage full of dress to handle the business. Suggest you do it with quickness. Or get the ring in your bell like Jehovah Witness. This
see good punches. Beautiful combination. Keep it up. Put the pressure on him. Great job.
Baby, you look good.
coming up next, a UFC lightweight division bout. You know, we trot out the term well-rounded in modern-day mixed martial arts maybe more than we should, but this guy fits the bill. Maybe doesn't stand out in any one area on film, but plus skills everywhere. And you gotta think tonight, Joe, with his skill set, he's more than comfortable really anywhere this fight goes. If he needs to stand and strike, he can do it. If the fight hits the canvas, he can submit you. A lot of different skills brought to the table by this young man.
This guy is very well-rounded. He literally has no weaknesses in his game. He is technical in all areas of mixed martial arts.
So here he is, a very accomplished striker, finally making the walk to the octagon tonight. Gotta think he'll be interested, of course, in keeping this fight standing in his wheelhouse. And he's got the takedown defense to keep this fight where he wants it, no doubt. He'll be looking to put on a striking clinic here tonight.
This guy is an outstanding striker. What he wants to do is use his defense to keep the fight standing, use the takedown defense in a good solid sprawl, and if he does go to the ground, make sure he gets back up and punishes his opponent.
And now our tale of the tape for this lightweight scrap. More than a decade separates these two fighters when it comes to the age, with some differences in height and a similar reach. Here once more is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is three rounds in the UFC lightweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, a mixed martial artist holding a professional record of 4 wins, 4 losses. He stands 5'10" tall, weighing in at 154 pounds. Fighting out of London, England, Frank Tye. And now introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner, a kickboxer holding a professional record of 4 wins, 1 loss. He stands 6'1" tall, weighing in at 155 pounds. Fighting out of Mecca, Saudi Arabia, Golden. And when the action begins, our referee in charge, Dan Mergliotta.
Dan Mergliotta.
Are you ready? You ready?
Well, always great to be back in Houston, Texas. Good to have you with us tonight as we get underway with live UFC action from Toyota Center. So he lost his last fight by vicious KO. All of that said, as round one gets underway here, he hasn't lost his confidence. You sit down with this young man here during fight week, and he's still unshakable. He still believes that his ceiling is UFC championship. Some people have questioned that given the way his last fight went out. But again, when people have doubted this young man, that is when he has turned in the biggest performances of his career. He is looking to do just that here once again tonight. All right, so there's a swing and a miss from him, and sometimes when you miss, it can tax your gas tank even more than when you land a strike. So clearly, it is energy preservation time at this point of the fight. Trying to kick the leg out. Oh, he got cracked with the jab there, Joe, and his head is firmly on the center line, the one place it really can't afford to be. He's showing some vulnerability here by leaning right into his opponent's range. Let's see if he can make some adjustments here. That punch will work right through the guard. Very nice leg kick for him there. Can't take too many of those.
Good straight right.
Oh, how about the multiple strikes landing here? That is a serious offensive barrage.
That one hurt.
Unable to connect with the right hand.
Nice jab. That was a very quick combination. He's doing a great job of mixing things up here.
And he eats a right hand there. Oh, another head kick lands flush. He has got to start blocking these, Joe. One more, and he could be down on the canvas looking up at the lights.
Caught him with a punch.
Oh, a lot of volume here. Good series of strikes there. And really nice job to finish the takedown there. Oh, and he escapes up to his feet. Very nice.
And he doesn't get it. He got tagged there.
Oh, man, that cut is getting worse by the minute. Looking ghastly at this point. Throws a big right hand, but doesn't find its home.
Nice right hook to the head.
Lands that kick to the leg.
Oh, and he hit a front kick.
Well, one got through. That kick was blocked.
That's a nice clean shot.
Really swung everything into that kick, but fell short.
Hit him with that straight left there.
20 seconds to go in round one.
He's got a beautiful leg kick.
All right, there's the clapper. 10 seconds to go.
Five minutes
in the books.
Here's a big leg kick. Here's a nasty head kick that lands. And another perfectly placed strike. Incredible striking on display in that round.
Brittany Palmer with us. Round two underway. Lands a punch. Well, there's no denying his status as one of the better grapplers and Brazilian jiu-jitsu practitioners on this roster, but his striking needed to be shored up. So, to that end, he has switched gyms from a BJJ-based camp to a striking camp, and his confidence as high as it's ever been as he gets in there tonight to try to show all the improvements he has made on the feet. Nice outside leg kick there. We show you the total strikes.
Hard hook.
All right, so some fatigue striking, I guess you would call it here. He is landing, but just not inflicting much damage because his stamina is on low. Well, he walked into his opponent's range there and ate that hook. He was unprotected, unguarded, and he's been susceptible to that hook in previous UFC fights. Got to figure out a way to move those feet and ultimately circle out and get that head off the center line.
What a nice single. Look at that. Beautifully executed sweep. That is a gash.
Wow.
That's crazy.
Ground and pound strike there now. Left punch is true.
Oh, this fight's close to being stopped.
Oh, unbelievable!
Goodness! Oh, my goodness! And here's the end of the fight. Let's take a look at that again. And here we see it one more time. Look at the timing in this shot. Boom.
Well, hard to perform much better than he did tonight. A huge knockout under the lights. They'll be talking about that one for some time. Now we go inside the octagon. Bruce Buffer with the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Dan Mergliotta has called a stop to this contest at 2 minutes, 19 seconds of round number 2. Declaring the winner by knockout, Golden!
So there's the man of the moment, just the way he drew it up here tonight as he gets his hand raised and does so emphatically by way of the KO. Perhaps some bonus money is coming his way at the end of the night. I'm not sure. Still a few fights to go. But at the very least, you can be sure his next fight will be a big one, and he will celebrate deep into the night with his teammates, his coaches, and his friends after this monumental victory here under the bright lights tonight.
I don't go out my circle.
Ain't nobody watching for ya. Ain't nobody watching for ya. Ain't nobody watching for ya. I don't know all my circle. Ain't nobody watching for ya. Ain't nobody watching for ya. Ain't nobody watching for ya. I don't know all my circle. Wait. How do you feel? That you just go walking with us? I don't know you. Give me shit to be the better. Matter of fact, give me better. Because if you don't, the wolves behind me telling me, let me at them, let me at them. See God, it ain't me. See God, it ain't me. They about to start a world war. I'm just trying to practice peace. Whole mood about to change. This why I don't come out. Cause it's always what? Try to act a fool out here, dumb out. I don't rock with you, homie. I don't rock with you, homie. I don't go out my circle. I don't go out my circle. I don't rock with you, homie. I don't rock with you, homie. I don't go out my circle. I don't go out my circle. Ain't nobody watching for ya. Ain't nobody watching for ya. Ain't nobody watching for ya. I don't go out my circle. Ain't nobody watching for ya. Ain't nobody watching for ya. Ain't nobody watching for ya. I don't go out my circle.
Right, coming up next, it's a UFC lightweight division bout.
Hardy, busted, Hardy, busted, Hardy, busted, 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 Hardy, busted, busted, Hardy.
Well, Joe Rogan, this is as accomplished a kickboxer as has made the walk to the UFC octagon as we've seen in the last several years. I'm excited to see his kickboxing skills on display in this particular matchup. Really a nice arsenal of kicks. He'll attack that lead leg beautifully, not to mention the solid punching technique that he brings to the table. This man is a danger for anyone in his striking range. When that octagon door closes, we're expecting fireworks tonight.
This guy is an outstanding striker. What he wants to do is use his defense to keep the fight standing, use the takedown defense and a good solid sprawl, and if he does go to the ground, make sure he gets back up and punishes his opponent.
All right, so here he is, a very accomplished striker, finally making the walk to the octagon tonight. Gotta think he'll be interested, of course, in keeping this fight standing in his wheelhouse. And he's got the takedown defense to keep this fight where he wants it. No doubt he'll be looking to put on a striking clinic here tonight.
This guy is an excellent striker. What he wants to do is utilize his footwork, his takedown defense, and land hard strikes to get the victory.
We'll be right back. now are tail of the tape for this lightweight scrap. More than 5 years apart, with similar height and some differences in reach. Here is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is 3 rounds in the UFC lightweight division. Introducing first, fighting at the blue corner, a kickboxer holding a professional record of 5 wins, 1 loss. He stands 6'1" tall, weighed in at 155 pounds, fighting out of Mecca, Saudi Arabia, Golden. And now introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner. This man is a kickboxer, holding a professional record of 4 wins, 5 losses. He stands 5'11" tall, weighing in at 155 pounds. Fighting at a line in Holland, the Netherlands, the Assassin. And when the action begins, our referee in charge of the Octagon, Dan Mergliotta.
So Dan Mergliotta shares the cage.
Ready? Are you ready?
Well, a huge night of live UFC action coming your way as we get underway from United Center here in Chicago, Illinois. All right, ready to go for round one, and it's hard not to harken back to his last appearance. A huge knockout victory for him that set up this particular showcase here tonight. Can he keep the momentum going, work his way towards that top 10, and register another knockout? His fan base is swelling. He is more popular than ever after a big knockout win his last time out. Well, he got cracked to the head there, Joe. He's going to have to change things up here with his footwork, with his tempo. He continues to be vulnerable to that strike coming back. Got to get his head off the center.
That one hurt.
Oh, great kick to the head there.
Huge uppercut misses.
And he connects there, Joe.
Beautiful kick to the body.
Oh, useful, well-placed kick there.
He got tagged there.
Good punch.
And he continues to work on the inside of that lead leg. Using his jab effectively here, Joe. Able to check the high kick. Yep, not a ton behind it, but it landed. Try to establish that jab.
Oh! It appears the cut on his cheek is getting worse.
Oh, that was a big left hand he connected with.
Oh! Kick lands. And both guys really throwing with authority.
Kick. Caught him with a punch.
All right, so some fatigue striking, I guess you would call it here. He is landing, but just not inflicting much damage because his stamina is on low. Oh, and yet another overhand connects, Joe. This could be trouble for the opponent. He's landed several of those here in this round.
He's really doing a good job of controlling distance and getting off these shots. Tries for a low single.
First takedown attempt is there. Switching stances here. 5 minutes in the books.
And here's a nice shot, lands perfectly. And here's another clean shot that lands. And another perfectly placed strike. Incredible striking on display in that round.
Brittany Palmer doing her thing as usual.
two. You ready? You ready?
All right, round two. All right, round two underway. Round one, pretty entertaining. Not the greatest round of the year, per se, but pretty good action on both sides. Joe Rogan, your thoughts on what we saw from either fighter through those first 5 minutes?
Whoa! He hurt him! This could be in! Oh! He clipped him! He's got him!
Now goes in and secures the takedown.
Oh, look at that. Get that back to his feet.
Oh, he lands another strike to the body, really starting to connect on a lot of shots to the midsection. And these will take their toll as this fight goes into the latter rounds.
Absolutely.
Oh, tagged him.
Well, why fix what's not broken? Why not go right back to that overhand here again? Look for him to throw that overhand here again. Well, you'll see a lot of fighters do this, Joe, as he lands another punch right at that opponent's eye where the cut is. It's a good strategy as they try to continue to work on what is starting to be a pretty significant cut.
Oh, huge block!
That cut onto his eyebrow is really pouring blood. They can stop this fight.
Oh, how about that? He lands a huge kick!
Hurt him with that right!
Well, a really good second round for him thus far. After a somewhat lackluster first round, he has found the rhythm and found his striking range. Scary proposition for the opponent now here in round two. Oh, look at him snap off the jab. That's pretty to watch. Beautiful employment of the jab here.
Excellent movement and transitions here on the ground. Staying busy. Big body punch. Yeah, he's back in the half guard here. Beautiful punch.
Just over a minute to go, round two. Oh, nice job working hard, posting, and getting back up. Well, Joey seems to have his opponent's timing down. He has landed some good shots, but nothing really in terms of multi-shot combinations, and perhaps that's why his opponent's still standing. So perhaps at this point, he could change up the power with which he throws some of these strikes, maybe alter the tempo a little bit, and try to make it so it's not just one and done when it comes to his striking attack.
Tags him.
Good check of the leg kick, Joe. Seconds here of round two.
Nice kicks.
And that's the end of round number two.
Let's take a look at it again here. Let's look at that from another angle. Let's take a look at it from a different angle.
Ariane Celeste is holding it down.
Final round, you ready?
Third round underway.
He's definitely going to want to start this round off fast to try to pick up where he left off. His opponent was in big trouble.
Oh!
He's out! He's out! Beautiful, accurate uppercut that got him the win.
Yeah, Joe, just the way he drew it up as he gets the knockout victory here tonight. It's hard to land a strike more flush than he did right there, and I'm not even sure the opponent saw it coming. So he'll see the replay and probably shake his head, but ultimately this is a huge result and a huge win for that fighter here tonight.
Let's look at that from a different angle. Here we see it again. Crank right on the jaw.
Well, hard to perform much better than he did tonight. A huge knockout under the lights. They'll be talking about that one for some time.
The official decision is in. Here's Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Dan Bergliotta has called a stop to this contest at 15 seconds of round number 3, declaring the winner by knockout, the Assassin.
So there's the man of the moment, just the way he drew it up here tonight as he gets his hand raised and does so emphatically by way of the KO. Perhaps some bonus money is coming his way at the end of the night, I'm not sure. Still a few fights to go, but at the very least, you can be sure his next fight will be a big one, and he will celebrate deep into the night with his teammates, his coaches, and his friends after this monumental victory here under the bright lights tonight.
Powerful, but they don't do no good. I know my blackness powerful, and they don't like that. I know some soul there, sit back.